Let's start talking about Christmas films, beginning with one of my childhood favourites, The Muppets Christmas Carol. Hi, my name's Drew and welcome to another review video on Flying Veena. Last year I covered the two Netflix films with the Christmas Chronicles 1 and 2. This year I thought I'll go for a film that I haven't seen in ages. For some reason I had completely forgotten about The Muppets Christmas Carol, one of my favourite Christmas films as a kid, if not maybe even the favourite film. Completely forgot about it, I haven't seen it in over 20 years. Remembered it last year, couldn't find it on any streaming service, was too lazy to go out and grab it anywhere, but this year it's actually on Disney Plus, which I'm very happy about. Straight off the bat, I have to say, I was never a big Muppets guy, so I didn't really watch any of the regular shows or other films. I am really not familiar with the Muppets. While I liked them, in, for instance, The Christmas Carol, it was never enough to really pique my interest to say, okay, I want to go out of my way and actually see more of them. So, I don't know. So, everything about this review you have to take from somebody who is not a big Muppets guy. In that sense, I've seen, I'm more of a fan of the other things that Jim Henson has done, like in Labyrinth, for instance. So, The Muppets Christmas Carol. As with everything else, a brief explanation of what the plot is, just in case you're not familiar with A Christmas Carol with Charles Dickens' famous story. We are focused on a guy called Ebenezer Scrooge. He is known to be a very, very depressing character, I'll call it. Well, he himself is not depressed, at least he doesn't see himself that way, but he goes about his day being very, very grumpy, particularly at Christmas. He's known for being a miser. He really does not like spending money on any kinds of things that would help out people, so he really, really hoards his money, and he's known for his grumpy attitude, particularly at Christmas, as I said. His employees, for instance, they have to sort of half beg just to get the day off at Christmas time, which he reluctantly gives them. And on Christmas Eve, he is visited by two ghosts of his former partners, and they announce to him that he will be visited by three more ghostly spirits, one at every hour, and they will try to change his fate because otherwise he will be doomed to be in chains for the rest of his life in supposedly hell. They never outright say hell, but I suppose they're referring to hell, just because he's been such a nasty person to all the people around him in his life. That's essentially what happens. The three ghosts, you have one that is the ghost of Christmas past, one is of Christmas present, and one is of Christmas future. And they show him various scenarios from his own life or from people that he knows, and they try to gradually change his opinion and outlook on life. Now, I won't tell you exactly how it goes. You will probably know the story anyway, and this is a particular kid's version, you will expect what happens, but yes, that is the plot, as far as that's concerned. And the interesting thing here, where the Muppets come in, is that we've got the Muppets just mixed with ordinary people, so it's not like it's only just Muppets, they're just part of society. No one even just makes an issue to address or anything, they are just among the population. Actually, we follow Gonzo and Rizzo, Gonzo being the particular focus because he is being Charles Dickens in this story. So he is our narrator and he actually guides us through the whole story. He actually talks directly to the audience, so there's fourth wall breaking here. This is a review, so I am not going to be just reliving old childhood memories by talking about this film. I am actually also looking at it a bit from a critical point of view, seeing what things I can learn of it, having not seen it in 20 years and obviously having a very, very different view of films nowadays. And I must say what I really liked, something that really stood out to me, was particularly in the beginning where we see the really, really grumpy Scrooge and we see all these dark alleyways and dark insides of houses, etc. I really like the camera work there. So just the whole mood that they set, it was really creepy, I felt. It was sort of borderline scary at times, with the camera sort of looking up, you know, from a lower vantage point, and also maybe it being at an angle. I thought there were some really interesting shots there. Like I say, I really enjoyed them. I liked the mood that they set, and for a kids film in particular, I thought, you know, it's really creepy, so it really, really gives you this feeling of Scrooge is just not a nice person. So I like that they didn't just tell you this outright and showed you what he does or doesn't do when it comes to giving money to charities, for instance. But they also just do it with the whole setting and the camera work. And let's be honest, Victorian London is a really creepy and scary place when you think about it. I mean, the perfect place for Jack the Ripper, if you ask me. You know, I mean, it's not a surprise that that kind of thing is what we really think about when we think about things that lurk in the dark. So I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the Muppets inclusion. I think it's a perfect medium. I mean, this is a very classic story. And for myself, I just think that the Muppets really make it awesome for little kids because they are just funny. I like the jokes. I will say I also like the jokes. There's not silly humour. It's not just kids' humour. It's just very sensible humour, I call it. Very, very situational as well. But I just enjoyed just the whole film when it comes to its comedy. It's got a lot of heart, as you can expect. And I do feel that the Muppets are also a big part of this. So again, they're a very good choice to include them. One thing that is very, very strange, and I actually read about this and heard about this last year, is that for some reason they cut one scene in the middle of the film. Now this is slightly spoilerish, take that as you will, but there's one scene where we visit a past Christmas, and it's one where Ebenezer Scrooge is actually in talks with his fiancée. They're planning a wedding and they're in a bad financial situation. And she is basically explaining to him that she has fallen out of love with him. And then she sings a song. Now, it's actually a very important scene in the film. It was so important, in fact, that even after 20 years, once the film finished, I was like, wait a second, there's a scene missing in this. They cut it because they felt that it dragged the film a bit. It wasn't too exciting, kids wouldn't enjoy it. All these things, it just made it a bit depressing, etc. But I still feel nowadays it's such a weird choice because it's one of the most important scenes, because while Ebenezer Scrooge is shown to have always disliked Christmas and not found it interesting or important or anything, you can see that this is the moment where his character really broke, you know, because the love of his life just left them, basically. And while last year they announced that all new versions of the film will have this scene included again, I watched it on Disney Plus yesterday and the scene was still cut, so that's really strange. I had to rewatch it online just to remind myself of it. Such a great scene, you know. Really sad that it's omitted in so many versions of this film. Also, one thing I do have to say with a bit of a critical eye, to me, the transformation, the journey that Ebenezer Scrooge does here isn't really believable in this version of the film. Now, there could be more reasons for it. One of them is not Michael Caine. Michael Caine does a great job. I really, really enjoyed particularly his grumpy Scrooge. I thought it was great. But also when he's the happy version towards the end, I feel that he does a great job. Now, it seems that just what they had in the film was just too little to really make that into a convincing story. I get it. I mean, we're also focused quite a lot on the Muppets, of course, to keep it entertaining for kids. And that may be where the focus was shifted to, but I feel they could have made the film maybe just a bit longer. It is a rather short film. It's less than an hour and a half. Maybe just add another 5 minutes or so where we have certain scenes where we can see more about him just, you know, thinking about his ways and what he was like and what he's missing out on, etc. I think just a bit more would have been needed to make just this whole journey really convincing, because in the film it is more or less like he's just suddenly okay with it without really having anything that you can see as the basis for this change. So again, that would be a criticism that I do have. Other than that, I feel it is really a perfect Christmas film. You've got entertaining songs, scenes. Like I say, the Muppets really are a great choice for this kind of story. It really is quite a perfect film. I can't wait. My daughter did watch it in parts yesterday, but only being a year old, you can imagine it's not really something that she's into yet. But I really look forward to sharing it with her in a few years' time. By then, hopefully, they will have included the missing scene again. We'll see if they manage. We've got a few years' time to do that. So if you're looking for a suggestion for a great kids' film, if you haven't seen this in particular, you definitely should watch it with your children if you're looking for such a suggestion. It holds up, of course, because it's a timeless classic. The whole tale is set in those times, so it's not like we see, maybe a modern family, just parents telling the story to the kids, and then we have a flashback or something like that. None of the sort. We are in the setting, so due to that, it really is a timeless story. and just all wonderfully done. The Muppets, the practical effects with all of them, you know, you really get lost in it and you forget that at times that, that these are all puppets and a lot of them are actually being steered and maneuvered by hand. It really is amazing. A very glowing review for me with just a few things that I find weren't quite okay. Very worthy tale for Christmas time. Let me know in the comments down below if you've seen them. If you have suggestions for other Muppets media that you think I really need to see, please share that below as well. Because like I say, it's just something I never got into. There might be other things out there that they've done that I would enjoy. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share and subscribe. It's the best way to support this channel. And I will see you in the next review video here on Flying Veena. Take care.